My cultists, and welcome to a very special video. As you can see, we have some visuals this time. Though it's not exactly what I had planned, as I still need to do some experiments in my house to get the correct setup. But I did want to bring you something a little special. So today, we're going to be looking at some of my personal dragon collection for you to enjoy. And if you're new here, welcome to the cult. Our first item is this beautiful dragon dagger I bought from a coworker a few years ago who was doing a declutter. Can see a little bit of clay from a time that I tried to make a mold of it to make a more cosplay friendly version to bring to a con. You can see the beautiful dragon head flowing into the body to form the handle. Its wing and claw making beautiful arcs, and another dragon forming the sheath. It's made of metal and wood. You can see on the other side that it's just as beautiful. Let's unsheath the dagger. And you can see the blade is very beautiful as well. You can appreciate the whole thing. The blade, metal too, of course. I think it makes the most excellent fantasy ritual dagger. worry. It's not sharp. Being more of a display piece. Just put this beauty away so that we can look at everything. And for those of you curious, this is actually the fabric I used for the velvet noises in the tailoring video. Joanne's a few years ago, but I didn't really know what I wanted to make with it, but I think it serves well as a temporary backdrop for us. Go to the next item I have. This is beautiful. Dragon oil candle that I picked up from one of those medieval dinner shows when I was quite younger. I've never had the heart in me to burn it because it is so beautiful. Dragon on the front seems to be made of pewter. So it's a simple metal one. It still looks like a beautiful little potion bottle. wonder and mystery of days gone by, mixed with the enchantment of magic, of myth and fantasy, are brought to you in our beautiful oil candles. By land of myth and not ink. Not sure if they're still around, but I thank them for this beautiful candle that I've had for years. I think it's time to bid farewell to this item too. Smooth out our fabric a little bit. This beautiful porcelain teapot. My father brought me from one of his business trips to China a few years ago. Probably more than a few years. See as this beautiful painting of an Eastern dragon on it. And the spout appears to be some sort of fish, which I believe Eastern dragons are known for having the scales. Is more sturdy than it seems. My tapping should not have any effect on it. Well, it is a bit simple. Looks like it has a river on it. I'm not really sure what that is. But it's still painted beautifully. One away too. Our next item is a bit more adorable. This is a dragon beeswax candle. Acquired at a craft fair when I was a kid. I have definitely had this for over a decade. I just cannot bring myself to burn it because it is so beautiful. So he sits on my shelf, greeting me with his beauty. Ridged belly, which can be cute. Well, I prefer the more dramatic dragons myself. He's got his wing in the back, all tucked in. Little hands, little hind legs, and a little tail wraps around his body, and the wick has been buried over the years. Does have quite a standoffish stance in. I'm not sure how well you can tell. I've always thought of him as my offended dragon. Always upset about something the others have done. I was very fortunate that my nails were not that long. As there seems to be no danger of me leaving any permanent marks on him. His wax is quite hard and so very well. can see a little bit of the wick poking out on his base. This beautiful dragon brooch. Which will be making special appearance in the future. This beautiful coppery metal. Some dark ruby stones. Its story is a little anticlimactic, as I found it on Amazon while searching for other things. And with that, I'm afraid I have to conclude our time together today. But my cultist, I hope you have a most wonderful sleep. Good night.